G'day hobbyists, this is going to be a quick video on painting Beastman skin. Now, these are my stage-by-stage models. And as you can see, I've got no paint, undercoat, base coat, and the first layer, followed by the second layer, and then the final layer. Now, the paints that I use for these guys are Mournfang Brown, Ratskin Flesh, Vestigore Flesh, and then Ungore Flesh. Now, that's four layers, which can seem like a lot for your just average guys in your army, but I think the results sort of speak for themselves. Like, you know, you get pretty good definition, good contrast there. And you can see his face and sort of see some of his muscle showing up. Like, I did these guys pretty quick, but you can still sort of see the flesh quite nicely there. And particularly on the facial details as well. Anyhow, but if you want to take that even further, like you want to go even further than four layers, you can mix Ungore Flesh and Screaming Skull. And just mix them together, say 50-50, put them on even more raised, more prominent edges, you know, the eyebrows, tips of the nose, tips of fingers and knuckles, and raise muscles, and that can lighten it up further. You could even use very thin Ward Dance from a Skull for a last really extreme edge and point highlight. But if you want it quicker and easier, and you're having trouble with getting the layering to work for you, you can just wash with Agrax Earthshade to give definition. Like, I could probably give this guy a wash of Agrax Earthshade to make his sort of recesses stand out more. But I'm quite happy with how that turned out. You don't even have to use all four layers. You want to make them quicker and a bit dirtier, then you could just use these three layers and maybe give them a wash if you want, and that'll still look pretty good. This is one of the guys that I was going to show off how I paint this particular skin. It's just layering, which means you leave a little bit of the previous layer showing in the recesses. You know, it gives you a bit of darkness, bit of contrast, and sort of shows the sort of recesses like in the muscles and in the cheeks and around the eyes, you can see there. Anyhow, I'm using a detail brush. That's the one I like to use for sort of any sort of man-sized model, their layering and such. And a bit of water on the palette. Put a tip on the brush. Put a bit of that Ungore paint on. Let's see if I can quickly and easily show you how I would do that face. That's a very good angle. That's actually, it's a terrible angle. Maybe I'll start with the arm. So just gotta layer it on, sort of getting the higher parts of the flesh layered up like that. Now, I always like to sort of put my wrists together and have my elbows resting on the table and such. Yeah, that's pretty clear. Right. Put it on like so. You don't want to have it too thick. You want to have it a little bit watered down. That way, sometimes you have a bit of the previous layer showing through this current layer. And that can actually help work as a guide for where you need to keep highlighting it. Because if some of previous layers still showing through this layer on your sort of raised surfaces, then you probably need to put another layer to sort of cover that up and sort of just accentuate those raised edges a bit more. At least that's what I like to use as a guide. Like, I'm probably using this paint a bit too thick for what some pros would say. Like, pros always tell me thin your paints more, so you want to have a slightly watered down paint consistency, and then just sort of layer it on, work your way further up and such, and you're just covering. You're covering a lot of the previous layer, but you've got to leave sort of enough to sort of separate the layers, like when you look at it, so you can sort of see some of the previous layer further into the recesses, and as you get further into the recesses, it gets darker and darker. And with four layers, that gives you a lot of definition and a lot of good detail. That's not fixing enough. There we go. And if you ever get the highlight layers into the recesses and it sort of ruins the layering, you can just go in with Agrax Earthshade to give that detail back. Get, like, sort of show off the recesses again. Is it gonna focus or not? With the sort of hands, I like to draw lines on the back of their hands, sort of accentuate the bones of the hand and the knuckles, and gives you that look. And with the face, the thing you want to get with the face is the cheekbones, the nose, the eyebrows. You want all of that sort of prominently shown. See this clearly. Pretty awkward panning around a camera, but I'm hoping that you can sort of see what I'm going for. Nose, nostril flares, and the mouth as well. Now, sort of the lines of this guy's mouth are sort of, you draw straight down along like so, and I can get a pretty good result going like that, and then get his cheekbones while you're at it. And you just accentuate the whole face. And you go for the even paint the wrinkles of his forehead if you want to. Give that nice look. Get his lips nicely.
Can get his lower lip next. That's still showing nicely.
There's a lower lip, and I find I use sort of vertical sort of brush strokes on the lip to sort of give it a sort of crease look, you know, sort of make the wrinkles appear a bit. And just work your way onto his forehead again.
I'll try and get the side of the face in the shot for you.
So I just paint along the base of his jaw, then his cheekbone there, along the sort of side of his brow, and then just lightly sort of get the sort of the middle of the cheek, and the other sort of section of his jaw, along his chin there a bit. I mean, along his, what would you say, his mouth. Then pick out the ear, like so.
I don't paint a lot of ungores. I mostly went with gores and beskores because I reckon they're better in the game and such. But you know, I'm not here to talk about gaming. I'm not a really good gamer. Painting is what I sort of really am in the hobby for.
And pick out the back of his head, like so.
Now with the sort of flatter areas of his head, you can sort of use a bit more water paint. Just sort of draw strokes along areas you want to sort of create texture or sort of show off. Like this, I'll probably put this paint on a bit too thick and generously. Oh, and I'm turning it away from the camera, but that's roughly how I paint Beastman's skin, and it's the vanilla sort of on the box method. Like, you could paint their skin sort of snowy gray, you could paint it reddish if you want to go for a sort of corn look, or you could paint it diseased, like my lovely Nurgle Lord from the previous video, which his skin was very similar to the Ungor's. Like, I start with a Mournfang base coat, but I worked up to Bugman's Glow and Cadian Flesh Tone, and then I washed it all with a Biltong Green, and then I worked some more layers on with Screaming Skull and a little bit of Cadian Flesh Tone, mostly Screaming Skull, and got that nice unhealthy look.
Oh, well, thanks for watching, and I hope this video has been helpful.